series of totes that have been filled up with a certain mix from their mixers. Now when they're ready to transport these, when they're ready to move this to the making line, they take the totes and they will put them on the stand, which then feeds, discharges directly into this transporter. This transporter will hold an entire tote, so it fills with this, and then upon demand, this is a dense space transporter, it will actually transport the material down through this line here. Goes up along the wall through a diverter valve right here. See the actuator, and it goes either to plant one, which is the line that goes over here, or it goes to plant three, which is basically straight through the wall. So it's going to convey there. Now, based upon the selection here, control system is here. They choose which feeder they want to go to at which plant before they transport, and everything has to match. The number of feeder that's programmed to receive that material has to match where they're trying to send it to. But then it'll be pneumatically transferred to one of two plants to the correct feeder. We'll now go take a look at the making line. Okay, we're going to plant three right now. The pneumatic main line is coming through here. As you can see up at the top here, it goes through another diverter valve right here, and it goes to one of four receiving bins, which is up on, as you can see here, I can see two of the bin vents, and here's the third bin vent filter you can see there, and that's going to the making line. We're on the back side of that right now where the hoppers and feeders are located. Okay, we're now at the making line. See, here's where the receiving hoppers are, and you'll also see right there. Feeders are located. Four feeders on this line, one header feeder. That's both the header and the face. And three additive feeders. Okay, this is the header feeder right here. You can see material being fed in. Bottom feet right here. So we're looking at the material. on the top level control arm to stop it. So the heaters are designed for mass flow. To ensure you don't have to have any operator interface. You can see the top of the hopper, but you can see them. The weld in place. The dust dot goes near the placement. And there's a matching path to look inside if you need it. To disassemble these units, we take off one clamp. This up, drive it down, and the whole crate will drop away so you get instant access if you needed to for any reason. Okay, we're now at the back side, the bottom of the header feeder. You can see here's the header feeder right here. You can see the special arrangement, the discharge arrangement on here. So what we're doing, we're looking now at the recycle system we designed and put in. There's a screen on top of the topper so we don't let the great big chunk fall down into this, but the hopper is then fitted with a special level control.
There's a flagging valve here and a special venturi inductor we use for this application.
So what we're doing is taking anything that's coming off the header and we're conveying it pneumatically through this line here. And as we're doing it now, we're coming up. You see through this. Go through a special hammer check where we just an elbow at the top. Right there. We go right back into the receiving bin itself. We have the option to connect here and go through another pipe and come out to a secondary receiving bin that's fitted with a vent filter up here. And an air-actuated gate at the discard end to fill totes if we don't want to recycle that material for some reason. As you can see, we've got a belt conveyor underneath here. Here's our venturi inductor and our reclaim system coming up. This is taking up, in this application, about 40 inches total. It can be less, but that's what this is taking up approximately here. And one of the major improvements has been there's no dust plume in the environment here. You can see we're actually feeding a red material, which is one of the dustiest, dirtiest materials. You can see there's no plume at all. Dust collection was connecting the plant prior when we used to have totes in here and belt conveyors to the other type of heaters. As you can see now, because of the change in the seal from the hopper, the receiving bin, all the way to the top of the complete seal system until we're discharging right here. Based upon that, there's just no dust. You can see there's no plume here. The dust collection is working well. That's been one of the really big advantages to the system as well. We're here looking at the very top of the reclaim system here. Here's the screen we were talking about where the material's falling through. There and there. Here's the header box on one side and header box on the other. So that is a short case history of Hanson Monroe Plant 3. We're now Plant 1 in Monroe. Here's a couple of the receiving bins there, and here's a few more over here. This is a real squeeze to get these units to fit in. They go down, try hard to see the feeders from the background, but the feeders are underneath. These units will sit up on the front side in a second. This is where it's pneumatically conveyed over. I can see the conveying line right here. Look for the white ceramic elbow in here. There's one of them. It comes over, makes a good turn right here. Goes up and goes up into the receiving bin. Okay, here's a couple of the feeders that are coming down from on the receiving bins. They're not running today at the plant. But here's two feeders we had to put in a very small area with some sub units in here to feed the column. Go across the wire cutter. Header feeder being used right here. Down to the two feeders. You can see here it's a much better view of the one as well. If we wanted to convey outside, we can go up to the copper, go on outside, and we have a ductwork outside. All right, so here we're outside now, and again, if they choose to come out to this bin, they don't want to reuse the material, they'll go into this reclaim system right here.